So is he ever going to find out that there's zombies? Seriously.
I have the same exact question. And I don't know. We're still I'm still waiting for it. I'm with the fans. I'm still waiting to find out if he'll find out too. I think it's going to be fun. I think it's going to be interesting. I think it'll be fun to play.
Yeah.
That, and I think it'll be a real world reaction. And I always say that for Clive, if he knows that zombies exist, that means there's vampires, that means there's werewolves, that means there's, it's like a Pandora's box. So, so we'll see.
Is there a reason you think that he hasn't? Like, is he somehow in denial? Do you have a theory as to why he hasn't figured it out yet?
Zombies?
Yeah.
I don't think that would be like the first conclusion he'll come up to with someone who has like white hair. You know, we've seen people, he does think she's goth, but I don't think that he'll go, you know what, or she's either goth or she's either a zombie. You know, I don't think that he'll jump to that conclusion. You know, like I said, the show exists like in the real world, you know, in terms of we make so many pop culture references. You know, he watches Game of Thrones, he's a hardcore fan. So I think it's equivalent to one of your colleagues, saying that they're a zombie all of a sudden. You'll just be like, what? It would just be a little weird. But I don't think
with this group.
Not with this group. There could be some real zombies here, yeah. So, like I said, in Vancouver, like, we see people who look like Liv, dress like Liv, the exact same thing, who walk among us, and we never say, hey, is that that could be a zombie. But his biggest deterrent of finding out is Liv. You know, Liv has been the biggest deterrent of him, you know, getting close to the truth. So being that he's working with a zombie, she's able to kind of keep him away from it, especially, and it's easy to keep it away from Clive because he's so tunnel vision. You know, he got his eyes on just figuring out who these killers are.
What are some of the cases coming up for Clive?
Some of the cases coming up? What was last week?
The burn victim.
Last week was the burn victim. This is the stripper episode coming up next. This is a fun one because it's not necessarily Clive isn't really working on that case. It's kind of, he thinks he has it figured out. But I think the stripper is witness in Allie's characters and Peyton's case. So you get to see more of Allie and Liv work together while Clive and Basio make headway on the Chaos Killer massacre and the Meat Cube massacre.
Where are you at with filming? Have you filmed the finale and everything? Or
So I know what's going to happen, so I got to really be careful of not to give anything away.
How much do you have to pay you?
I am taking a second to pause and make, you know, what's out there.
So when you read the finale script, what went through your mind?
I had no idea that it was going to go in the direction where it went. One thing I can give away, I guess, is that there's no, you know, the last two episodes aren't procedural. It blows up, you know, in terms of where in terms of what happens. But my reaction was, let me get on a treadmill, get in shape. There's a lot of some humongous stunts that happens in these last two episodes. And they just kind of shake things up, you know. But I was absolutely blown away by it. Couldn't wait to get on set and shoot it. Like, how are we gonna make this happen? This is ambitious. But we got it done.
Do you like the stunts? I mean, is that something you really looked forward to doing?
Yeah, I mean, and I when I was little growing up, I loved the Fall Guy, Lee Majors. I was a hardcore fan, and I used to be able to throw myself down a flight of stairs in high school just for fun. You know, and people think I'm hurt. I'm like, no, I'm good. I'm all right. But yeah, I mean, it's an opportunity. Hopefully I get, you know, that opportunity to do more stunts if a situation warrants that. But I love that. I love that. So there was little things here and there that I got an opportunity to do. I got a bruised butt bone, the left butt bone, a little bruised. I took a bad spill in my coccyx, that's what it's called or something. But it was well worth it.
Well, she hasn't. I mean, she changes her look all the time. Does your character ever question why she looks different each week? Like when she eats a brain, she kind of changes her hair and everything else. And but he never seems to ask her, why are you changing everything up?
That was actually a big, I think the first time, the first episode, it was probably episode 3 of this season, she's as the, she's wearing like the sexy dresses, and I'm like, how am I supposed to react to this? Because this is the first time she physically takes on.
Yeah.
She's physically transformed, and she actually looks like the people I'm interrogating. Like, how am I not going to say anything?
Right.
You know, and so I talked to Robin and the producers. They were like, trust. He doesn't have time. He doesn't have time to do that.
Mm.
You know, he notices it. And he's just gonna keep. He is that tunnel vision. He just says, "Okay, I'm just gonna let that happen." But that was like actually the first time. That was the first episode, and probably the only episode where she's took on like hardcore physical characteristics of the characters that is undeniable. Like, even with the old man in the first episode, you know, she could have worked out at the gym. Could be a little sore. I don't know what it is, but. But like I said, you know, it's staying true to the fact that Clive is this tunnel vision guy, and he's just gonna, you know, he's at work, so he just cares about getting the job done.
He and Liv have had some rocky moments here and there. I mean, will they stay pretty much on the same page through the rest of the season, or are they gonna have any more tension between them?
Any more tensions? Yeah. I think they definitely stay on the same page in a sense. I mean, obviously she's a little bit ahead of him because she knows that Major is involved in the Meet Cute massacre. She knows that, and she's actually his alibi. You know, if she wasn't his alibi, he would have made that case. He'll be probably get some big promotion, but she's like, you know, she's his big deterrent. I think it'll be interesting to find out once all that unravels whether or not their friendship and their bond can survive that. And then I think if it survives that, maybe Clive can be let in on what's really happening. I think she has to trust him with that. And in terms of everybody that she have told that she's a zombie, these are people that she came up with and she's been friends with for years, like Peyton. And she told Robbie, obviously, because he gives her hope, he gives her an opportunity, he's trying to figure out how to cure her. And obviously her fiance, but no one else, you know, no one else in that regard. And she's only known Clive for a year and a half, something like that, so she's definitely not going to tell him. He has to earn that, so. But they're becoming tight, and we'll see what happens.
Are we going to learn anything significantly new about him before the end of the season?
Anything significantly new? I guess you get to see a little bit of Clive's home life coming up.
Okay.
You know, it was interesting to see where he lived because I'd never seen it. So I was like, oh, Clive rolls like this. That's cool. So I thought that was fun.
So it wasn't what you imagined it would be?
It wasn't what I imagined it would be. Yeah, but it was nice though. It was very nice, pristine, clean. I'm like, he has a lot of, his home life is equivalent to his fashion style. It's very, very clean. But it's fun. I won't give everything away. But it's pretty cool when you go and see his place and the things he has on his walls, the books he reads. I thought it was very, very interesting. It just tells you why he is the way he is, and you know why they're so consistent with him being the character that he is, which makes it fun for me to play.